This product is for in vitro diagnostic use, over-the-counter use, and use with anterior nasal swab specimens. An anterior nasal swab sample can be self-collected by individuals aged 14 years or older. Children aged 2 to 13 years should be tested by an adult. Carefully review the instructions before performing the test. Failure to follow the instructions may result in inaccurate test results. For more complete information, refer to the Instructions for Use, IFU, available online at wanfousa.com. Materials provided: a tube holder as part of the box, a sealed test cassette in a notched foil pouch, an anterior nasal swab in a peel pouch, and a buffer tube with a twist cap. Preparing for the test. Do not open the test materials until ready for use. If the test cassette is open for an hour or longer, invalid test results may occur. Check the expiration date of the test printed on the right side of the outer box. Wash your hands with soap and water for 20 seconds and dry them thoroughly, or use hand sanitizer. Locate the tube holder on the box. Look for the red circle on the kit's box. Insert the buffer tube into the tube holder. Ensure that the buffer tube is stable and upright. Remove the large cap from the buffer tube and set it aside for later use. Remove test cassette from sealed pouch and lay it on a flat surface. Sample collection. Remove the swab from the pouch. Be careful not to touch the swab tip, which is the soft end, with your hand. Carefully insert the swab no more than 3/4 inch, 1.5 centimeters, into the nostril. Slowly rotate the swab at least 5 times against the nostril wall. Do not insert the swab any further if you feel any resistance. Remove the swab and repeat in the other nostril using the same swab. Check. Did you swab both nostrils? If you are swabbing others, please wear a face mask. With children, the maximum depth of insertion into the nostril may be less than 1/2 to 3/4 inch, and you may require another adult to hold the child's head while swabbing. Running the test. Immerse the swab into the buffer tube and swirl the swab in the buffer. Ensure the sample is mixed thoroughly by making at least 10 circles. Sample must be adequately mixed into the buffer, otherwise incorrect results may occur. Leave the swab in the buffer tube for 1 minute. A timer is recommended for this step. After 1 minute, pinch the tip of the swab from the outside of the tube to remove any excess liquid from the swab. Remove and discard the swab. Hold the buffer tube upright and screw the large cap back onto the tube. Ensure a tight fit to prevent leaking. Twist to open the small cap at the top of the tube. Invert the buffer tube and squeeze 4 drops of test sample into the sample well on the test cassette. Then, discard the buffer tube. Note: incorrect results may be observed if less than 4 drops of sample are added. Sample must be applied to the test cassette within 1 hour of mixing the swab sample into the buffer tube. Start a timer and read results at 10 minutes. Do not interpret results before 10 minutes or after 20 minutes. Inaccurate test interpretations may occur. Interpreting your results. Look for lines next to C, FA, FB, and COV. C is the control line, FA is the flu A test line, FB is the flu B test line, COV is the COVID-19 test line. A red line should always appear at the C position. This is a control line and signals that the test is working properly. Invalid result. Check to see if a pink to red line is visible at the control line, C, in the results window. If a line is not visible at C, even if any other line is visible in the results window, the result is considered invalid. If you do not see a C line, do not continue reading the results. It means your test is invalid. Repeat the test with a new sample and new test kit materials. Negative result. If a control C line is visible and you do not see a line at FA, FB, or COV, it means the test is negative. The flu A, flu B, or COVID-19 virus have not been detected. To increase the chance that the negative result for COVID-19 is accurate, you should test again in 48 hours after the first day of testing. If respiratory symptoms persist, seek follow-up care with your healthcare provider. Positive result. If the control line at C is visible, and any other line or multiple lines on FA, FB, and or COV are visible, the test is positive for that virus. Note, any pink to red test line, no matter how faint, should be considered a positive result when the control line is also present. Consult your healthcare provider to discuss your positive test result. Self-isolate at home per CDC recommendations to stop spreading the virus to others.